Praise the Lord, everyone. This is Pastor Rodney Smiling, coming to you again with more instruction from God's Holy Word and your daily drive-by. Yeah, listen, I want to talk to you all today. First of all, congratulations to the Green Bay Packers, who really did a great job yesterday. You know, there were so many haters that was out there that was talking about that the Cowboys were going to beat us, you know, and It was a match that was made really nicely because, you know, the Cowboys were, you know, 8-0 on the road and we were 8-0 at home. And so it was like this challenge, who was going to break first. And thank God, you know, things work out in our favor. Now, I will tell you that, you know, in my mind, I was thinking about that karma is a funny thing. You know, sometimes the things that cause us to gain access on one end will also be the thing that cause us to maybe trip up on another end, you know, and equally so from the negative to the positive. And so what do I mean by that? You know, because we can learn lessons from anything. And so, you know, I want to talk to you today about, you know, sometimes, you know, we can be blessed in one end. In relation to football, when the Cowboys were playing the other day, they received a call in their favor that many people were scratching their heads saying, oh my God, how could you do that? How could you make a call and then pull it back as if nothing was happening? For those of you who know football, you know what I'm talking about. But then here it is in this game against the Green Bay Packers. Yes, sir. We find that also they got a call, a touchdown that was also reversed. And shown that no, it's not a touchdown, and they actually lost. They could have won. And so what am I saying to you is that sometimes the blessing that we receive on one side can also be something that later on we can regret, and it could be a curse against us. Sometimes the Word of God says, if God be for us, who can be against us? But let's be honest, the truth of the matter is sometime when God is for you, people are against you. And it may be somebody that you want close in your life. It could be a family member. It could be a friend. It could be a child. It could be a loved one. You know, all of these things could happen. For Jesus says, he says that, do you think that I came to bring peace? He says, I didn't come to bring peace, but I came to bring a sword. And that sword is going to divide between the spirit of one and the spirit of another. So you could have a husband and a wife that are in love with each other. However, the spirit of the wife is different than the spirit of the husband. And so if the husband follow Christ, if the husband does the things of Christ, does the things of God, your family may be against you. The question is, what do you do? Do you fold? Do you give up? Do you give in? Or do you keep it moving? It is important to know that with every failure of life, with every situation of life, or every challenge of life, the question always remains, what do you do now? What will you do now? What will you choose to do now? Will you lay down and give up? Or will you get back up, dust yourself off, and keep it moving? My friends, I know that sometimes we will get a job, and those jobs may provide for us a blessing that we stand in need of. And then the next day, or the next year, or the next couple of years, that job is the same job that lays you off and puts you in financial ruin. What am I here to tell you? I'm here to tell you that sometimes the blessings of today can be a curse tomorrow. Can be something tomorrow. But if you are a child of God, if you are the blessed of the Lord, it doesn't matter what circumstance you're in, what situation you face, every day is a day of thanksgiving. For the Bible says, in all things, give thanks because you are blessed. You are blessed abundantly. The fact that you got up today to breathe is a blessing. The fact that you can move your arms or your legs or can blink your eyes, or the fact that you can smile or you can speak or you can hear or you can see, is a blessing. So count all your blessings and you will find that those things that are against you are minimal. That's why the Word of God says, greater is he that is in you than he that is in the world. If you put Christ on the scale in your life and you would measure everything else against you, I'm here to tell you that Christ is much more for you than those that are against you. So God bless you today. Have a marvelous day. Make sure you celebrate with me and Green Bay Packers. Yeah. Okay, Cowboy fans, listen, better luck next time. Now we get ready for the Seahawks. And so, you know, that's going to be a challenging game. because the Seahawks are playing really aggressive, but I believe in my team, and I believe that they're going to do well. God bless you all. Have a blessed day.